Hey everybody, welcome back to another Stoneface Reactions. I'm Griffin, that's Theta, and that's Chey, and we're here to watch some Made in Abyss, and we are here now at the first season finale, and it's going to be an entire hour.
47 minutes.
47 minutes, but you know, we're going to definitely talk about it, right?
Yeah.
Do we have to?
Last episode ended off with Reg being asked by Nanachi to kill Mimiku. So we're gonna get a whole hour of definitely painful death sequence, right?
Well, we're obviously gonna get flashbacks to who Mimiku was before they got transformed. Yeah. More than the 10-second flashback that we got two episodes ago, that some of you blinked and missed. It was that fast.
Yeah. That was literally like two still frames, wasn't it?
It was when we first met Nanachi two episodes ago. Not the one last episode where she's carrying her away from a mysterious person who I'm sure we'll also find out about this episode.
So you think this whole episode is literally just going to be her backstory, right?
No.
No? Okay.
He thinks we're going to get it.
Yeah, I think we're going to get it. I think we're combining two episodes worth of content together so that we're not... Like, they probably had some
sort of
emotional hook that they wanted to get into us and then score at the same time. Mm-hmm. So they combined it both into one episode. And then...
Yeah, that's like 10 points right there.
Yeah, so what would normally have been two episodes across, instead of ending one season and starting the next season on it, like a television show might. They decided, stick it all together. They're going to get the hook and the payoff all at once, and it's really going to hurt.
Yeah, I think I kind of agree with that. The whole point of this show is to try to make you feel bad by killing these kids.
Well, I suspect we're going to find out what an amazing person Miku was, and then we're going to get emotionally invested in them. And they thought,
Reg has to kill him.
We can't just introduce them. We have to really hook you in. Mm-hmm. And we didn't have enough time to do that before. So we'll do an hour long. And here we are, about to get emotionally invested in Miku, so that we can then watch them die.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, sounds about right.
A character death doesn't really mean anything if the show doesn't give you a reason to care about them.
Exactly.
If anything, it would mean more for Nanachi for us at this point, because we don't know anything about the other one, really.
Which would also be a fair way to put everything. This is Nanachi's story, right?
That's the way I'm seeing it, but I also know that I'm biased and didn't want to state it like fact.
Yeah.
Well, it's also one of those odd positions where this is the type of anime where everyone's drawn cute and adorable, right? So you instantly have buy-in, unless you're the type of person who doesn't find the art style appealing. So they can get away with introducing a cute character and kill them. Because you're like, oh no! The cute character died! Because human beings are the same way that babies are cute. You don't want to kill a baby, right?
It's a natural defense mechanism. We evolved to be cute babies.
And then we recognize that thing in other creatures, which is why kittens and puppies are cute. And that's why the art style is cute, to make you attach to people more quickly than not, which is why you could kill somebody faster in a show like this without having a backstory, because you instantly want to see more of them.
It's just a really weird one for me with this series, especially because in this setting, when you're as far in as you are, death seems like a mercy. I feel like letting you live is the real torture there, so... pretty interesting.
They've already introduced too.
Well, we covered it in like episode one or two of you're never gonna see your friends again. I mean, unless they come down, which seems unlikely, because then they'll never be able to see their friends again. Unless you formed like a chain. I'm only gonna go 1,000 feet down. My other friend's gonna go 2,000 feet down. And we just start sending messages back and forth.
That's a really awful way to have a friendship. Just stay on the surface, kids.
Yeah, no one likes pen pals.
Not when there's, like, an alternative, right?
Except for those old lonely women that marry people in prison.
Hey, you know, it'd be like that.
All right. It well, before we start sending a bunch like of letters, let's go ahead and watch the episode then.
Uh oh.
We're getting all the flashbacks.
I was about to say, Reg did use his power before, and he hasn't passed out yet, so. So yeah, by the laws of the universe, Rick should pass out any minute now.
I do love the framing of it.
That's right, Mitty, not that name that you said, Griff.
Yeah, y'all were saying Mimikyu, which is a Pokemon. I was just letting it go because I couldn't remember Mitty.
We covered this in the Symphogear recording that we're all bad with names.
Oh, unrelated thought, but when you were talking about the lonely prison women who marry people in prison, right? I actually just watched She-Hulk with my friend, and that was like a whole plot line.
Oh, it sure was.
There's seven soulmates, yeah.
I think. I watched like the four or five episodes or something. Yeah, that's like two and three, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really liked that show. I just finished it this morning.
Which is weird, because they don't show back up later when you meet him back at his compound.
Yeah, that is a little weird, huh?
For the She-Hulk stuff, I think the show lacks confidence in its own thesis, and that's kind of what makes me go, ah, I wish it was better.
That's good.
Everyone else complains about other things.
It's good.
The whole show the entire time is telling you what its identity is and then sticking to it. I don't know what you're talking about.
It's constantly trying to reference other things and say, it's like, oh, just trust me, we're going to get to a cool superhero fight, we swear.
Well, the whole point is that she was Deadpool before Deadpool was Deadpool, you know? She breaks the fourth wall, it's her thing.
But it literally doesn't say that thing you just said, Griff. In fact, the last episode goes to it, and she says, no, that's not what we're doing. That's not what the show's about.
It's yeah, actually,
the
it was,
opposite
it was pretty
of
great.
What you just said.
I'll find you a reference later.
Anyway, now that we're done with She-Hulk spoilers during the intro sequence,
oh,
not that
now
like any of you
out.
Care.
Pass out just after that.
Oh, we haven't seen him actually get any, like, actual damage, have we?
Maybe he's using a limited resource every time he fires the gun.
Yeah, seems like it.
He's gotta build it back up again.
They come from another place that has another hole in the ground.
Our hole has a hole.
Also, nuclear winter? World War III, am I right? Previous
Maybe.
Theory?
Is this the pit where all the, like, abandoned slummy houses were?
No. Because they weren't painting over the giant ringed island thing.
It just looks like it.
Because they're like in a completely different place, it looks like.
Is this Nanachi?
Yeah. Because Mitty had red hair.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the same
bad guy.
Or at least look. They're doing the Squid Game mask, so it's hard to tell.
He's got the skull hand whistle.
Abyss の探掘家、白笛です。
Dude looks super high tech for the rest of the world.
He really does. Artifact, maybe?
Decked out in that wealth by level.
Has to be an artifact. Unless, again, this positively is like a different part of the world. So they could have higher tech. Okay, I'm changing my opinion. I think they were in a different part of the world and then it came here. Like the ships that we saw last episode. They're using these orphans as test subjects.
Yeah, they are.
I'm more impressed they have a whole vehicle for going down there. That's kind of amazing.
Feels like it would be easier just to strap everyone to the sides of the thing and drop it like the Mars rover. Big old cushion balloons around the outside.
Just chuck it in.
It feels like this is the way to do it at a garbage dump.
Yeah, that's the pick a classmate tactic right there. It's like, oh, you don't care about anything, so I guess you're my partner now.
Well, I don't remember if I said it before, but I was thinking that Mitty was going to be the one who's like experienced or the bigger part of the duo. And that's why we're left with Nanachi.
Yeah, Nanachi's a very tame character for all intents and purposes. Very, like, small energy, I guess.
Definitely a bird, not a monster.
These kids need to stop being so happy so that I feel less when they all die. Like that moment where they heard the noise.
They are all dying.
Oh, they heard the noise. And you see all these fucking innocent faces look up at the light. Like, fuck, I don't need that. I need at least half of you to start picking on the other half of you. So at least I can feel 50% less bad when you die. So this is about 6,000 feet lower than our main characters currently are.
With a highly visible force field, too. Or maybe only they can see it.
Well, if there's working technology down here, maybe that's where they're getting their helmets from. They're wearing suits that allow them to go up and down. Those adults have been down here before.
ナナチマジすごいね。
さすが私の相棒だね、ブレインだね。まあな、絵も上手だし。イリム、さ、来てください。
はーい。
Again, you guys have no reaction to it. I think it's fucking world-breaking. They have suits that allow them to go up and down, Griff.
Oh, right, yeah, their technology lets them go through the force field without any penalty, yeah? Or maybe they are transformed underneath it.
Now you're making me change your camera.
Sorry, I gotta do this for the dog.
Was there a way you could scoot your chair over a little bit?
Meaty. Meaty.
No, I don't think there is. I could do this, though.
That works. Did you read up to Chey? I mean, you read the One Piece manga, you said, right?
I was for a while. Now I just keep up with it through my friends.
But I mean, did you get to the part with the, I can't remember his name, is the gas fruit user?
Yes, Caesar Clown.
Yeah. This reminded me it... a lot of the kids that he experimented on.
I was getting the same vibe, yeah.
しかし、タンクツカならともかく、負荷的に二度と戻れない子供たちはその人道的に。ああ、なら心配ありませんよ。あれらは人間としての運用はしておりませんので。 ご覧になります?
Realizing the hoarder.
Meety. Nanachi. Meety.
Oya.
First of all, perfect timing. We've clearly got two test tubes there.
They just wanted to walk them in separately.
<笑>深海6層に行けるんですよ。降りた先は袋小路なんですが、いろいろと試すのにちょうどいい深さでしてね。私の箱庭なんです。6層の呪い。 しか人間性を失うか、なんとかしたいですよね。あなたが入ってるそれ、呪いを片側に押し付けることができるんですよ。人とそれ以外ではうまくいかなかったんですが、ちょうどナナチも来てくれたことです。可愛らしい生態を2つも使うのは惜しいですが、2人とも仲良しです。きっと成功しますよ。私たちが
She's been the face of confidence this whole time.
Time
to sacrifice the kids.
では始めましょうか。
So Nanachi got lucky because somebody else was absorbing the curse for her.
Pretty much.
You know, at the very least, what they could have done is not made them clear test tubes. So you have to stare at your best friend.
Yeah, but that's something you do for humans. He's not treating them as that.
Man, this dungeon drop ride is terrible.
They also said before that they weren't previously testing them on two humans. But I mean, at the same time. The whole pit is full of the failed experiments.
Wow, yeah. Just leave them down there.
I'm not going to be able to do it.
The fluff begins.
Jesus.
Yep, that's pretty horrific.
Jesus.
Literally melts it.
That was visceral.
Yeah, jeez.
I mean, not just because they're friends, too. That was her only friend.
Like, the only thing they treasured.
Ever.
Nanachi. Nanachi. Aikawarazu, kenkyu mo tetsudawazu ni oekaki desu ka? Kimi wa kawaii desu ne. Sou sou. Miti ga uketa noroi ga wakarimashita yo. Subarashii kekka desu. Ano youna fukusanbutsu ga eraleru to wa, yahari abisu wa kyōiteki desu. Nijū ni uketa noroi ga kanojo ni motarashita mono wa, ningen sei no soushitsu dake dewa naku, shinenaku naru mono datta no desu.
Which is why you're asking Reg that you know he has a superpower like that. Try and kill her. And you've been torturing her this whole time, too.
すりつぶした葉の手足も生えてきています。蘇みがえるのはこれで9回目ですが、少々形がいびつになる程度で済んでいます。
Just really rubbing that.
I'm glad that they waited till the last episode. I don't know if I'd be able to watch this show if it started with this shit.
Yeah, that was.
Not only did you result in the horrific transformation of your friend, you also caused them to be tortured for eternity. I hope you're happy.
She didn't cause that.
I know, but that's how the guy is presenting it. Because he's a jerk.
I assume the only reason she kept hanging out there was to try and find something to reverse it.
Not her Stockholm scenario.
And her last request was kill me.
Dameda.
That's a crazy character arc.
Yeah, jeez.
She's devoted her life to finding a humane way to kill her best friend.
Well, I mean, at this point, I know she just said that, but at this point, it seems like any way. Because we just saw her try everything she could to try and kill her.
How much of that backstory did Reg just get?
I have no understanding how Nanashi is smiling at all.
He's clearly made her peace with this decision.
I think
she's happy because she feels she found a way to save her friend.
Well, Well, yeah, he's given that the backstory was a bunch of your soul gets released when this and this, so...
Or just her default mood, I suppose.
Well, no, obviously not that. How do you go through all that shit and be their default now?
Because they're the same character.
あんなにも頼もしく思えた君が今はひどく儚く見える。ここにあるおびただしい薬も毒も全てミーティーの尊厳を取り戻すためのもの。それが君の生きる理由なら。ミーティーを殺した後、君はどうなってしまうんだ?
I don't think she cares.
I mean, easily still cementing Nanashi as the best character of this show.
I like her. She's the best.
Well, I mean, look at all the shit she's had to go through just to have already become the best character of the show before we right. even knew about it.
Just, like you said, cementing it.
Well, I mean, you just told me the worst story I've ever heard. That should've weighed on a person. Well, right. Explains the previous thing where she was cooking and didn't understand her meal was bad because she's used to eating the worst stuff out of a garbage dump.
Right, the best stuff she tastes is bland. Just enjoying watching him fail.
I mean, if I was in his position, I think the best I'd be able to come up with is like pork rinds. Just skin the beast and then really just cook the shit out of the skin. Oils and whatnot.
I love how her face lit up for that.
Oh, she just used to it. The way the show can go from complete tragedy to to this.
I'm just glad we didn't start with Maiden Abyss today, because I would be scarred for couldn't the next few episodes.
This is why I told you we need to end the set on this show.
Because every time we go back to her, like, in Midi's room with little dolls and toys and treating her like a little kid and knowing now the backstory, and it's like, fuck, man.
You just gotta live with the tragedy now.
Well, no, she's actively trying to end it. But... No.
Things are, in fact, not good.
Well, I assume that's why she's not bustering about it, because you can't tell somebody a story like that, and they're not going to go through with it.
Of course she's thought of that already.
オイラもそのうちどうにかなって死ぬ。そしたらミーティーは永遠に一人ぼっちだ。ミーティーはさ、物も食わないし死ぬこともない。けど刺されりゃ痛いし涙だって流すんだ。それがただの反応だとしても。<笑>
永遠に苦しみ続けなきゃならねえ。悲鳴すら上げることもできず、魂を囚われたまま、永遠にだ。レグ、これは最後のチャンスなんだ。ミーティーを解放できる。最後の。お願いだ。こんなに都合のいいことは、二度と起こらねえ。
了解した。ナナチ、約束してくれ。
Just to distract myself from the emotional distress I'm going through right now. Do you think Nanashi is also somewhat immortal now?
Is also what, sorry?
Somewhat immortal.
I don't know.
I don't think they've tried to find out yet. There's only one way they'll find out.
I don't think so, because all of the curse went to the midi side of the tank for the most part. And he said that the immortality came from doubling up on it, right?
That's probably true. I was somewhat distracted by other
Fair.
things going on in the scene. Like the fact that they had been torturing her so much that her guts were on the back wall.
Yeah.
Not a lot of emotion showing on here. A lot of emotion showing right here.
Nah, I get that.
Oh my gosh, all the stuffed toys.
Like I said, it's the fact that she's treating her like a small child is like doubling down on the heartbreak.
Absolutely.
Oh man. Viking funeral style, but surrounded with toys and shit.
Jeez.
This is like end of old Yeller shit.
Literally. Except it's got lasers.
Okay, more like of Mice and Men. Look at the flowers.
She can't even break herself to do it even then. Oh my gosh, the fake out. There's absolutely no one happy with the scenario.
You can't just throw us, Liza. We need a second.
I guess the only thing to do after that sort of tragedy is to completely disassociate, right?
Well, no, because he passes out for 2 hours, so maybe this, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there you go. You're right.
No, just we the viewers need a second, dang.
Gosh, yeah.
And now that she is recovering from her thing, and do you even tell her?
You absolutely do not tell her a single thing about anything that happened.
やみ上がりだから食いやすいシチュー作ってやろうとしたら、オイラの作り方にケチつけてくんだよ。異様な匂いの正体はこれか。まず取り除いたりしたら味しないだろ。いいからいいから。換気もして4層にも済んでたんだね。いいよいいよ。
They're already getting along perfectly. Rag, you've been replaced.
お前、見てねえでどかしてくれよ。こいつオイラ見ても。Rag, you've been replaced.
First taste of real food ever, Ingumen.
Literally ever.
Brings them to tears instantly.
Now offer some to Mitty. Rico, go ahead. Too soon? Yep, there it is.
Of course she notices. Bring up the trauma.
I mean, because she only saw her in that fever dream thing that she had. She's been unconscious for the entire time.
Oh, they're just gonna start bawling after the story. I can see it now.
Well, we've still got another, like, 12 minutes.
Yeah.
He's got to be having some kind of like weird flashback to being inside the death box, right?
Oh, I thought it was more of a manifestation of the curse.
Oh, probably, actually.
Since the last episode, we had the curse being represented like a, I don't know how to describe it. Like, literally a layer thing that goes over top of you. And she described her dream starting up in between two layers.
Gotcha.
その子ね、振り向かずに行っちゃったんだけど、横顔が見えたの。
私がずっと見てきた探掘家たちと同じ憧れに溢れた目。それで私、自分が何になりたいのか思い出して、行かなきゃって思って。その時ね、私またあの子に会える気がしたの。そしたら目が覚めて。
Yikes.
Well, I mean, technically.
Oh my gosh.
Technically, you will, because according to their whole thing, Midi's soul is now in Nanashi as well.
Liko の命は、もしかしたらアビスと深いところでつながっていて。
Leg. いいんだ。
It was not, in fact, all right.
今度はちゃんとお前が守ってやるんだぜ。
リコ、
ん？
実は。
Oh no, he told her.
ついたぜ。
I mean, they don't hide anything from each other. ここだ。Especially their buttholes.
まだ見たことない不思議な獣も入りに来るんだぜ。
大丈夫なのか?
Look, I already cried. I let everything out already, so I'm free again.
深いところは刺激が強いからやめときな。
うん。下から光が来てる。
うん。
レグごめん。一人で脱げないから手伝って。
ああ。リコ、脇開けて。
ねえ、レグも一緒に入ろう。
僕は見張りをするから。
入ってやりなよ。たまにハムシが注水に来るからな。追っ払うのは得意だろう。見張りはオイラがやっとくから
さ。Nanachi remaining the best character.
足元結構滑るかも。気をつけて。
私たち入ったとこだけ色が避けてく。レグ見て見て、お湯なのにちっちゃい魚もいる。魚が浮いた赤食べてるよ。
なんか喉が
大丈夫、お湯が染みただけ。レグ、チンチンどうしたの？
Of course, he is thirsty.
After all of that, this is what we want to end the season on.
And Nanachi just.
I understand I just made a butthole joke, but that was me, and I didn't write the show.
Mm-mm.
ナナチ、卑怯だぞ。君も入れ。
何言ってんのお前。ちゃんと見張ってるんで、ごゆっくり。
キューって何のこと？ねえねえ。
まったく、見てらんねえよ。ミーティ、ありがとな。レグの宝物、引っ張り上げてくれて。もう少し。もう少しだけ待っててくれるかな。
There we go. We actually end off with Nanachi having a reason to continue on after all that.
リコ、気をしっかり。
なあ、あと5個だ。でかいシーン行くぜ。しっかり押さえとけよ。
And now back to the horror, of course.
Hey, you guys are a little broke up over time.
I take it they don't have time for several weeks of physical therapy.
レグ、頼んだのは私なのよ。
でも結局はナナチが助けてくれて。
ナナチ言ってたよ。レグ、私を助ける間ずっと泣いてて一生懸命悩んでたって。それ見てたらね、あれはオイラだって思わず助けに出ちゃったんだって。レグ、この傷は証なの。レグが私を守ってくれた大切な証なのよ。
リコ、
ナナチ、
どうした？
まあ、もう何でもねえよ。お、
ねえナナチ。
まあ、
お願いがあるの。私たちと一緒に来てくれないかな。
いいぜ。
本当？ナナチ、嬉しい。いいの？
I mean, it would be harder to stay home now. Place is nothing but memories.
Yeah.
But they just go straight into being so cute.
お前はミーティーのお気に入りだ。途中で投げ出したら、次会った時怒られちまう。レグだけじゃ頼りねえしな。
ごもっとも。リコの料理も美味しいものな。
何何？
The true reason they must protect Rico.
おいら、お前たちが目指す場所から来たんだ。
それって、例の？
おいおい、だぜ。そんじゃ、早速準備するか。結構やることあんぞ。な、出発は早い方がいいんだろ。
Yeah, similarly, she wouldn't remember the path back that she took from there.
I'm so happy Nanachi's staying.
Oh, same here.
That makes me like twice as excited for the next season.
And whatever hell happens in the movie.
Oh yeah, oh, we still have the movie, I forgot.
It's only gonna get worse.
Sending a message back to the surface. Assuming that nothing thinks that's food.
Yeah, right.
Gonna miss.
So that's the third layer that thing just went through, right? Here's the second.
Got the inverted forest.
The real treasure was the friends we made in the other way.
No, that's the One Piece.
Oh, the One Piece is real.
It is.
I'm almost sad she didn't stop, open it up, and read everything in there. It makes perfect sense that she'd be like, oh yeah, I'll just send the balloon back on its way. That's where it's going.
Ooh. She doing it.
Rehabilitation. They are spending a couple weeks on it.
They have a safe spot within the abyss to do it. I don't see why not.
Yeah. It'd be crazy if this could go on further. There's that old shield generator.
That balloon could take a lot of abuse.
Remember, it already got fixed once. I guess not a lot of messages come from this deep.
And when they do, they're usually done through
the mega
channels.
Backpack. Oh.
I guess the only benefit of these packages is they obviously look different from everything else. So any relic hunter trying to find relics is obviously going to be drawn towards it.
Is that the same cliff Reg, like, decked a giant worm out?
No.
Oh yeah, that other one had like a statue at the end, I think.
No, that one had a giant Reg laser beam cold cut through it.
This is definitely the time we need to just process all of this. Just some quiet music for a minute.
Well, no, I mean, now we're trying to figure out what the message is.
What did we learn here today?
I assume it's being sent to Leader. Although that might just be what next season starts off with, and we're not learning
or the
now.
Movie.
Yeah, do you think they planned the movie first or the season first?
It could be a No Game No Life thing.
Yeah, that was a prequel.
I know, but actually in the light novels, it's done in the same order. They do that first stuff, then they do the prequel, and then they continue with the story in the light novels.
So something like a...
So that is the actual order.
Something of an SAO,
weird.
Then an SAO jumps around, but then they brought out SAO Progressive, which goes back and does it all in order. You know, if I was Anachi, I would have set the building on fire when I left.
I think that would set everything on fire. Definitely attract predators, all that.
Yeah, but you're not coming back, so it doesn't matter.
There's a lot of
moths there,
too.
There's the attract predators worry.
Catching it on fire might be difficult, actually.
Actually, I think attracting predators would help you, because the predators would be going towards that, and you're heading away from it. Oh, yeah. They could track that?
I'm impressed too.
I don't even mean like how. Movie. I think this might bleed right into the movie.
Oh, that's perfect, actually. Oh my gosh.
Wait, actually, no. It might not. I was going to say based on the name of the movie, but I was thinking of the name of the next season. Plus, this place is like 8,000 kilometers below them. I doubt they're just going to jump 8,000 kilometers down in the next season. We still have to go.
Oh, yeah, they have to actually travel all the way there. But at least we'll get more and more of this antagonist then.
Or not. I mean, he is 8 kilometers down. I don't know if he has the reach or not. All he has is a... What do you call them? The thing that keeps leeches alive.
Phylactery.
Yeah, apparently a bunch of phylacteries.
They did have like that whole story about like, oh yeah, you know, stuff that happens with your soul, it'll go back down to the abyss afterwards. Starting to think maybe there's more literalness in this. We'll have to see once it gets revealed, though.
I mean, we just saw the literal physical embodiment of a soul, like. Midi's soul manifested for Rico there, so like it's a thing. Souls are canon.
It yeah, there you go. They're canon and they go in the hole.
Well, I don't know. Midi's whole thing was that her soul was gonna go to Nanachi. So
And then it didn't.
What do you mean?
Well, as far as we're aware, her soul went back to the abyss, not Nanachi.
No, I would argue it's different.
When did it go to Nanachi?
Well, that's metaphysical. We don't have proof that it went anywhere, but that's what Midi was talking about doing, and that's what Nanachi wanted to happen. But the only thing that we saw was a light went out. So if that was like registering her soul, all we know is it didn't go back there.
I do appreciate also the final absolute confirmation that yes, the tragedy is over. There's no more Midi coming back and suffering. Midi got atomized, but I was thinking for a second, what if she comes back anyway? cell-style regeneration?
When Rico was going back over her dream thing, she already mentioned the smell of burning. So we know that's when MIDI vanish.
Ah, yeah, there you go. Yeah. That makes perfect sense.
Although, not gonna lie, like, I wanted to say it, but it was, like, such an intense, like, emotional moment in the show. I was just about to be like, yo, in before she just regens and creates an anticlimactic moment.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I, like you, Thanos, like, that hit me right here, you know.
Hard to tell with all the laughing.
It's called stress reaction.
I know. But it's hard for me to keep my actual emotions intact when in my ear I'm hearing... like the psycho kid holding a knife in a horror movie.
I just gotta make it difficult on everyone, don't mind me.
Classic Griff.
Still absolutely fantastic, though. This was...
The seed of chaos.
This show is just such a roller coaster, like up and down everywhere, right?
Well, that was the one scene that I was spoiled to that I didn't realize happened this deep in, was the whole kill me thing. Like I said, I think I saw it on some Watch Mojo, like top 10 anime twists or saddest scenes or something like that. So yeah. I'd seen the please kill me, but in my head, I remembered it being the character that looked like Nanachi and not a character like Midi. So I was still thrown off by everything. And it happened so long ago that I saw it that I totally forgot everything. So seeing it like that, horrifying.
Oh, gosh, yeah. What is there left to say about all this other than I think we'll be traumatized for the rest of our lives?
Yeah, I don't know. When I'm hit with like heavy emotional moments like that, it's hard for me to like form words, which makes the reaction part a little difficult. But well, geez, I don't really know.
It's not even that it was emotion. It was emotion mixed with body horror, because we saw her split up the face while screaming how much it hurts and that she wants to die.
It was so visceral. Like, I know I said that when it happened, but that's, like, the only word that, like, feels like enough.
And the culmination of all of that, friendship. Like, this is, like, we see her crawling out of a sewer pipe. Oh, you stink. Get away from me. And this is the only person that'll get close to her and is saying how great these little things about her that nobody gives a shit about matter. Like, I find pieces of trash in the garbage dump. That's perfect for down here. That's what we're all about. And I'm reading this book that tells me about this stuff that I found. I can't even read. Can you teach me to read? Like, her best friend, her only friend, is relying on her and telling her that all these things that make you special are the greatest things anybody could ever have. And then gets placed in a tube where she has to watch that only person in her life that has told her she's special and matters be torn apart in the horrific, most painful way possible. Begging for death.
And asked to be killed, yeah.
And we had the luxury of a couple cutaway frames to see her horror face. Like, she didn't have that luxury.
Oh, yeah.
You got to think about it from that perspective, too. Like, she didn't get a little half-second break like we did. It was all just real time for her. That's,
I mean, I would argue...
The fact that she, like, continued on like that is crazy to me.
I mean, I was saying the whole, what a divider in the tubes as a joke earlier, but at the same time, I don't know that you'd want to look away, because this is still your last chance to see your friend.
Yeah, right. I just know that I would be flinching. I don't know that I could have handled that.
I mean,
I think, like I said earlier, there's no person happy with this scenario.
No, I mean, like, flinching away, like, turned away, like, in a ball.
I mean, that would be worse, I would think. Not for, I mean, not obviously you're already going through the worst thing you could do, but imagine your friend is experiencing all this, and you actively turn your back on them.
Oh, totally, but I'm not going to think about that in the moment. I'm just going to beat myself up over it for the rest of my life.
What are you talking about? That's literally the only thing you're thinking
about
in that moment.
Welcome to the Nanachi experience.
I don't think you get that horror out of the back of your eyes. That's going to be what you see for the rest of your life every time you blink.
Oh, absolutely. I just know that I'm a coward and I wouldn't be able to watch it happen.
Hmm. Well, we have more horror awaiting us ahead, I think.
We've got
it's
a whole movie.
It's definitely not going to stop here.
A whole movie and a second season.
Oh boy.
Second season's near the top of the charts.
Well, I'm ready for more trauma. So I think let's go ahead and wrap it up for today and process all this.
Natural segue, Griff.
I know, natural
Mr.
segue.
Mr. Segue, as they call him.
I'm going to have a nice depression nap after this.
So I'm Mr. Segue, that's Theta, and that's Shy, and we will catch you all next time on Stone Face Reactions. See you next time.
Thank you, Mr. Segue.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching another Stone Face Reactions. If you have an idea of another video we could go ahead and watch, go ahead and put it in the comments down below, and we'll add it to the wheel. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and let us know what you thought about this video, what parts you liked. And until then, we'll see you next time. Is this too goofy?